Hey, what's up guys? Cody here with Cyber Geek Knowledge. Thanks so much for checking out this video. Today we are going to be showing you how to install a Facebook Pixel into your ClickFunnels account step for step. Make sure that you guys watch until the very end. I got a special bonus for you. If you guys haven't already, make sure that you hit that red button and that subscribe and that notification just so that you're informed every time I come out with new content for you guys. Other than that guys, let's go and let's do this. So what is a pixel?
The Facebook pixel is a few lines of code from Facebook that you copy into the header section of a website. This code allows the pixel to receive information about the actions taken on your site to make Facebook ads more relevant to your audience.
Basically, the easiest way to tell you is a pixel is a piece of code that's used to track visitors from ads to sales funnels to web pages to so on. It's a great tool to utilize, and if you're using Facebook ads, you should be utilizing this because it's a way for Facebook to optimize whatever it is you're wanting to optimize for, whether that's leads, whether that is conversions, whether that's engagement, anything at all. In the long run, this tool will actually save you a lot of money and make you a lot more. So it's definitely a must, especially if you are going to be running Facebook ads. I personally run pixels on anything and any kind of platform that I'm running ads on. Even my organic stuff, I'm still pixelating anytime that I can. So tracking is definitely a must in this game. So up until this point, you know, I'm gonna go ahead and assume that you've already got a product picked, you've already got a sales funnel built. I'm assuming that you have a ClickFunnels account and you've already got your Facebook manager and everything else set up. If you don't and you have no idea what I'm talking about or anything else like that, guys, go check out my channel, check out my previous videos. I'll show you how to do all of this stuff. But in this one, I am going to go ahead and in this point, we're going to go ahead and jump into my computer and we're going to walk you through exactly how to do this. So let's do it.
Okay, guys. So up to this point, you've already created your Facebook manager. You've already created all of your ad accounts. You've already created your fan page, your Facebook fan page. And this is a brand new account. So I'm going to walk you through step for step. Now we're going to go ahead and do your pixel. Okay. So after you've logged into your business Facebook page or Facebook business suite, you should be in your homepage here. Next, we're going to go down to more tools. Go ahead and click that. You're going to look for business settings. We're going to click on that. So once this loads up, we're going to go ahead and scroll down here on the left-hand side. We're going to look for something called data sources. Go ahead and drop that arrow down. You're going to look for pixels. Next, we're going to go ahead and click pixels. Now, obviously, because this is a brand new account, yours should look like this. Now, if you've got pixels in here, obviously, you're going to have other pixels. But up until this stage, if you've got a brand new account, you shouldn't have anything in here. This is what you should see. So we're going to go ahead and click the add button. You can name it whatever you want. It really doesn't matter me. I'm just going to leave it Cody K's pixel for this example. You know, you can always change this later if you want to. Check your website for easy setup. We're going to do this later. Don't worry about this. Just go ahead and hit continue. Next, you can either go to continue manage my business or you can set up your pixel later, but we're going to go ahead and set up pixel now. So we're going to click that. There are three different options here. You know, if you're using a partner integration, you can add the code, you can manually add it, or you can do email instructions over to a developer. If you're working with a developer, for this example, we're going to go ahead and do manually add. Now this right here, this is all you need to really pay attention to, this little block. Go ahead and click on this. That's going to copy it to your clipboard. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to jump over here into our browser and we're going to go over to our ClickFunnels account or wherever you're placing this pixel. Okay, so for me, I'm going to go ahead and just place it in this one for this example. Once you get into the funnel, open it up. You're going to go ahead and go into settings over here on the right or top right side of your opt-in page or wherever you're wanting to place the funnel, I should say. Inside here, you're going to see it says head tracking code. Go ahead and click right click and paste that in there. Once you click off of that, scroll all the way down. Make sure you do this. Make sure that you save and update the settings. That is very, very important. So as of right now, your pixel is installed on your page. Now we're going to go back into the business settings over here. We are going to scroll down and we're going to go ahead and check this, right? So go back here. We'll go back and click on our home opt-in. We'll get this URL, whatever your URL is right here. Yours may look a little different. Mine is customized. I know a lot of people's is like a bunch of random numbers and letters and stuff like that. So whatever it is, it doesn't matter. Just copy that and we're going to paste that into our URL. And we're going to go ahead and send traffic, or send a test traffic. And I strongly do suggest getting the Facebook Pixel Helper. It's a Chrome extension if you are using Chrome. As you can see here right away as we fired, you can see right here it says page view. And it does show Cody K's Pixel, which we just set up. And then there's the Pixel ID. So as long as you did it correctly and then you've gotten to this point, you know, you should be able to test this and it will show that your page view is indeed firing, your Pixel is indeed firing. You can also go back into your Facebook Business Manager account, and after you do this, if you don't have the Facebook Pixel extension, just to make sure, if you scroll down and you see where it says step number 3, test the base code, it'll show this green dot right here where it shows active. Go ahead and hit continue. As of right now, you are pretty much done. You can just go ahead and hit cancel and you now have a Pixel. Here is your Pixel right here, your Pixel ID. Now, I know a lot of you guys are doing affiliate marketing with people like ClickBank, JVZoo, Max Bounty, Warrior Plus, whatever. What you want to do is you want to copy this to your clipboard and go off and write an email up to whoever you're promoting for, whatever that product is, you know. Make sure that you copy this into an email and email them and ask them to put this into their purchase confirmation page. And then what you can do is you can come back in here and create an event and create another purchase pixel that will show that, hey, you're getting leads and you're getting purchases. Guys, I hope that this was helpful. I hope this was informative. You know, definitely if it was, like, comment, share. Definitely want to get this algorithm going, get this out to as many people as possible. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification button. That way you guys are aware every time that I come out with a new video. I try to come out with one at least daily, if not every other day. Each video that I do, I will get more in depth and more step by steps for you guys. If you guys ever want to learn anything in particular or in specifics, feel free to reach out in the comments or join my private Facebook group. I will drop a link below for you guys. Again, I appreciate you guys checking this out, and you guys take care. See you in the next one.